No, it was originally recorded in 1943 by Bing Crosby. So, this next one again is an instrumental, so I get to sit back again. It's Frosty the Snowman, and this song gained enormous popularity after it hit the market, as it seemed to fit a sequel for Rudolph. Recorded by Gene Autry and Lady by Gene Durante. In the lyrics to Frosty the Snowman, what item held the magic? Do you know? It was a hat, yeah. The old silk hat. When he put it on his head, he began to dance around. So, Frosty the Snowman.
1, 2, 1, 2.
Notice how hard I work with these bells. It's incredible.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, they said that the inspiration for this song came from bells used by sidewalk Santas and the Salvation Army solicitors. It was first performed by Bob Hope and Marilyn Maxwell. Enjoy our rendition of Silver Bells. nice. Okay, now we're going to give Rob a chance to do something other than sitting there tapping on those drums.
Well, they told me you needed help.
Impromptu.
Ralph just has some fun. confidence even then.
Pardon?
She just had a little confidence.
I know. People don't realize it, but I'm a very shy type, actually.
I'm coming back to
you. Okay. But as soon as he finds that, I'm going to do a Carmen Manco. With Mary Andrew and Andy. And I'm going to sit here, just looking pretty, of course. What can I say? California, and in the midst of a heat wave. Lyricists Kahn and composer Stein were in just those conditions and imagining cooler conditions when they wrote Let It Snow. Although the lyrics make no mention of Christmas, it had become a regular on the radio stations during this season.
Thank you.
very different. Okay, this is the last song coming up before we go to the sing-along, which we hope you'll all really make a lot of noise for. So the last one, it was written about Santa's ninth reindeer. Actually started off as a poem commissioned by the Montgomery Ward Department Store to be given away to children by the Santa Claus employed by the store. It proved to be a wonderful success. The musical version was written by Johnny Marks and recorded by Gene Autry in 1949. The rest goes down in history.
One, two, three,
virtuosity, and even keeps in time sometimes, Andy, doesn't it? So we're going to get on to this sing-along now, which